So far, we've talked about creating and naming data frames, importing them, and the Tinyverse package. Now, let's get more close and personal with them and learn about subsetting data frames. We've already talked about some of these methods when we were covering matrices and lists, so I will try to be super quick when glossing over familiar stuff. First, I will make use of the Tinyverse and get a dataset from the Deplayer package that's called Star Wars. It's stored as a tibble, which as we know is just another take on the data frame. There are benefits to using a tibble instead of a data frame, but that usually works best for the more advanced Star user. Alright, I will save the data as a data frame, and I will remove the last three columns because all of them contain lists and that will make exploring our data difficult. Excellent! Now that's a pretty large data frame and it isn't very efficient to print all of it when we do an operation. So from now on, whenever our data frame is hefty, I will use the head function. It is part of a set of functions that act like a sanity check and only show you the top 6 or the bottom 6 rows of your data. Like this. This is a great way for keeping tabs on whatever you're doing without flooding your console with data. Alright, so, subsetting. In terms of notation, all the usual suspects are here. We can subset data frames like we would subset a matrix, or like we would index a list. To index a specific element, we use square brackets, row index, comma, column index. So, if I want to know where R2D2 is from, I need to call this. Or I could use the column name instead of its number because it's easier. To ask about all the data on Princess Leia Organa, I must reference a row. This happens by passing her row name in the square brackets and leaving a space for the column indicator, remember? Alternatively, if I want to see only the character names but nothing else, I can call the first column, leaving a space for the rows. I will use the head function here because 87 rows is too long. Or I can borrow from the list subsetting notation and use double brackets to call the name column. Notice that in the first instance R returned a data frame and in the second a vector. Why does that happen? Well, remember how lists behaved when we were subsetting them in the previous section? Double brackets drill down to the individual elements and extract them without keeping their larger structure. The same thing happens in data frames. Why? Because they're two-dimensional lists. Excellent! Now, lists could also be subsetted using the dollar sign, and that stands true in this situation as well. And just like with lists, we don't need to use quotation marks around column names. Again, R returns a vector. One last way to reference a column but get a data frame in return is by using single brackets and column name inside quotation marks. Like this. Okay, and how about if I want to extract multiple columns for a subset of characters? We can use the combine function to specify what exactly we're interested in. Easy. And that returns a data frame too. This is sweet. Alright, now we know how to subset a data frame to operate on whatever part of it we need. That is fantastic. But what if we got some new observations and wanted to add them to the structure? Or if we isolated a new variable and wanted to attach it to the data frame? You guessed it, we will cover that in the next lesson. Thanks everyone, see you in the next video, and of course, may the Force be with you.
For more videos like this one, please subscribe.